I feel like a member of the Losers Club, and Pennywise knows exactly what terrifies me. That's right. It looks like Jessica Chastain, you know. In her defense, it seems that she's never given up, neither has Andy Muschietti, the director. But she actually managed to get herself in talks for the role of adult Beverly Marsh in It Chapter 2. This has been something that they've been talking about since the movie came out. Andy Muschietti was like, I'm gonna do it. And Jessica Chastain was like, I wanna do it. And everyone else was like, please don't do it. But maybe, and because of the success of the first film and Warner Brothers wants to keep their director happy, they've at least decided to entertain discussion of her coming on board as the first cast member, no less. Oh, it's so bad. And Muschietti, he even cast a young actress who looks like Chastain. That's how long this nefarious plan has been going on. It kind of backfired a little bit, though, because Sophia Lillis is like the antithesis of Jessica Chastain. She comes across as warm and kind and doesn't have a huge ego. All right, so anyway, to be fair, I can understand where Andy Muschietti is coming from, right? Because Jessica Chastain starred in his first big Hollywood movie, Mama. So they're friends. She helped him out early on. Their careers were both coming together. They bonded, whatever. But why should we, in this blossoming franchise, have to pay for that friendship? Because get this, Jessica Chastain doesn't have a lot of other friends in Hollywood or with moviegoers. I mean, you've seen her desperate tweets. It led to me saying Jessica Chastain has never seen a bandwagon she doesn't want to hop on. And she's like that girl in school who runs into everybody else's group photos. And you're like, you weren't with this group. We don't want you in the photo. And she's like, too late, I'm here. And when anyone looks at the yearbook, this will be what they remember. But you know, for instance, she tweeted about Wonder Woman and Atomic Blonde. And you'll note that nobody ever follows up with her. She's never like, here's me with Gal Gadot. I think, did she corner her like at the Golden Globes or something, right? She's just relentless. And now she's gonna bring down the It franchise in that relentless pursuit. But then also the Atomic Blonde, you never saw anyone from that movie being like, thanks, Chastain. They were like, get away from us. Her only real friend is Octavia Spencer, who, and that is an earned friendship, because Jessica Chastain got Octavia Spencer the biggest payday of Spencer's career by demanding they be paid the same for their upcoming Planes, Trains, and Automobiles type movie. And they succeeded both beyond their, you know, the wildest dreams for what they had both expected to get. So Octavia Spencer should be Jessica Chastain's friend. And that's a nice thing that Jessica Chastain did. But again, why does It have to suffer for that, right? I mean, playing adult Beverly Marsh should not be the reward for that. Because there's a rumor that she's as unlikable in person in Hollywood as she is on the big screen as she comes across. And on that note, Jessica Chastain has never starred in a successful movie. Not once. Audiences have spoken. It's like, remember when everyone was like, with Blade Runner, everyone was like, wow, Ryan Gosling's finally going to break through. But then it was like, oh, wow, that's right. People still don't want to see him. And he's a very, I like Ryan Gosling quite a bit, but nobody wants to see him. And the box office numbers, the box office writing was on the wall. And it's the same with Jessica Chastain. It's really scary for Dark Phoenix when you think about it. But she wasn't two big movies, but she, you know, so maybe this will be Dark Phoenix as well. But she had a supporting role in Interstellar, right? She managed not to derail that. Although it was one of Christopher, you know, significantly underperformed from Inception, so, Also, she was in The Martian, but where she was famous for in that movie was saying, yeah, why didn't I get paid as much as Matt Damon? That was during the whole equal pay movement in Hollywood, right? And it's like, well, you didn't get paid as much as Matt Damon because he's the star of the movie and you have just a few lines. So what's wrong with you? All right, so how about movies she did star in, right? So Molly's Game made $28 million domestic. These are domestic grosses. Miss Sloan, $3.5 million. Crimson Peak, $31 million. Then she was in a big blockbuster or blockbuster-esque type movie, The Huntsman, Winter's War. She was the new female lead. $48 million domestic, less than a third of the total haul for the first movie domestically. Not only did she not bring anyone in additionally, but she couldn't even hold on to the original audience. Kristen Stewart outgrossed her. I would take Kristen Stewart. I would take anyone as adult Beverly Marsh over Jessica Chastain. That's how bad an idea I think this is. Again, Sophia Lillis, while they might look similar, Sophia Lillis, and I think, you know, I said before, Sarah Paulson would be a much better adult Beverly Marsh, but Sophia Lillis exuded warmth and kindness and was pivotal to the Losers Club, not only in the first film, but she will be in the second film as well. So again, I understand where Andy Muschietti is coming from, and I understand that Warner Brothers wants to keep their $700 million director happy. And Mama did okay at the box office, but it was a horror movie also as well, so, you know, cheating a little bit there, because there's always a strong audience. And that was early on in Jessica Chastain's career, before anyone knew just how annoying and unpopular she truly is. But I'm calling it now, okay? If they cast her on screen, you're going to get a mix of resting bitch face and Jessica Chastain trying to out-act poor Billy Skarsgård. And then off screen, you know, like a real look at me kind of situation. We're like, move over, Billy. This is my movie now. And you're like, no, it's not. It's an ensemble piece. And then off screen, she'll make some overly aggressive and dramatic political comment, either about the movie or something else that draws focus from the film. And worst of all, when audiences looked at Sophia Lillis, they saw Beverly Marsh. But when they look upon Jessica Chastain in It Chapter 2, they will see Jessica Chastain. So do you think this is a bad idea? I mean, it might be invulnerable at this point, but why test it? Why mar it like this? Share your own thoughts down below. It hasn't happened yet. Maybe if we're angry enough about it, it won't. And of course, you can check out some more videos right now, including who I think should be the adult cast for It Chapter 2. Bye.